When it comes to wildfires, every second matters. The Paradise Fire at its fastest was covering one football field per second.
You can see these huge spikes telling us thousands of users were actually going to Google.
Users wanted to know how big the fire was.
This is a story about technology with life or death stakes and a committed group of people focused on crises. To tell it, we're going inside Google to meet the team who helped create wildfire boundary maps. In 2017, Google's crisis response team launched SOS alerts to provide helpful information to people during different types of crises. However, there were no systems of maps to show people the current location of active fires in near real time, something the team was challenged to address. An engineering lead in Google's crisis response team wanted to solve this. Meet more.
Fast forward into 2018, I'm on a business trip in the Bay Area during the huge campfires, and the entire Bay Area was filled with smoke. How far is the fire from us? We could find maps that were 48 hours old. That's how large the latency was. This is where we actually said, okay, let's get serious. What can we do?
I was reading a few blogs. One of the blog articles I saw provided an animation of what the GOES-16 satellite actually saw on the ground. We could now get a really timely and really detailed view of what was happening on the ground that we can then translate to users in the form of a simplified boundary.
And this was this moment of paf. Okay, everything comes together, but from a proof of concept to a product, there's a huge journey ahead.
Once we developed our programs and we processed all the satellite imagery, we could compute polygons, outlines, and refresh every 5, 10, 30 minutes. The real question is this useful to users? How do we know that?
We heard over and over again when we talked to firefighters, listen, if you can tell people that the fire is near, it helps us do our job.
The team had a prototype that worked, but to launch on search is a very high bar, especially with information that can help save someone's life.
And we get in front of the VP for approval. We got the right product. We get the right metrics to show that we are accurate enough, and we get the launch approval.
This launch in 2020 marks the first time people could access an approximate wildfire boundary map on Google Maps and search that was updated in near real time. In addition to boundary maps, you can see contextual information like news and tweets from local authorities, local resources on shelters, along with safety tips from the American Red Cross.
I still have chills knowing that this solution is actually going to affect millions and millions of lives.
After launching wildfire boundary maps throughout the entire U.S. in 2020, the team continues to make improvements to the technology, working to expand availability around the world.